Right. So now we'll go for multi-stage centrifugal pump. So this is multi-stage centrifugal pump. These are the number of stages that you have it in the centrifugal pump. This is the first stage, second stage, and third stage. So totally you have 3 stages, okay, which are connected in series. How do you say this as series? It is simple. If all the 3 stages are running on the common shaft, if all the 3 stages are mounted on the common shaft, then we call it as series connection. And the purpose of using series connection is to increase the head, okay, to increase the head. So to whatever the height we wanted to lift, more the height, more the number of series connection we have to give, okay. When we are going to do parallel connection is done when we require huge quantity of water to be delivered, okay. More quantity of water is to be delivered means we have to have parallel connection. If we want to increase the head, then we have to have series connection. So series, multiple impellers will be running on the common shaft. Parallel, each and every impeller will be mounted on a separate shaft, okay. So this is about multi-stage centrifugal pump. Now how to conduct the experiment? Before starting, I will tell you, here priming is not necessary because there is no leakage here. Now here, whatever the gauge you are seeing, this is vacuum gauge reading. You can see vacuum mm in hg, mean to say this is suction side pressure gauge. At the suction line, this is the pressure gauge. So that is the reason it is vacuum gauge reading. Whereas here you have 3 pressure gauges. This is pressure 1, P1, that is first impeller, first stage pressure gauge reading. This is second stage pressure gauge reading, and this is third stage pressure gauge reading. Okay, so here you are supposed to take these 3 gauge readings. Okay, so this is 1, 2, and 3, right? Apart from these 3, there are 2 more gauges. This you don't consider. This is for some other experiment, so don't consider. You take delivery head 1, delivery head 2, delivery head 3 readings. Okay, so now how to do this experiment, I'll tell you. Here we can do only constant speed. Okay, we can run this experiment only for constant speed. So how to start the experiment? It is simple. This is one suction valve, delivery valve, and this is one more valve which is let out to the tank. Okay, so before starting the experiment, make sure this is parallel to the pipeline. When it is parallel to the pipeline, it says that this valve is completely open, and this also it should be completely open. Okay, not only these 2 valves, there is one more valve over here. There is one more valve over here. This is Pelton wheel nozzle valve. So this has to be completely closed. Why this has to be completely closed? Please understand, multi-stage centrifugal pump and Pelton wheel turbine, it is a clubbed experiment here. We have a common experimental setup. So if you open this, instead of water falling in the tank, you can see the water gets into the Pelton wheel turbine, so which should not happen. So that is the reason we are supposed to completely close this valve. Okay, so completely close, those 2 valves completely open. This is the first initial setup that you are supposed to do it before you start the experiment. So once everything is set, start the machine. Once it starts for fully open, you can see here this reads 1.8 kg per centimeter square, outer scale reading, black color. 1.6 kg per centimeter square, it should read 1.6 kg per centimeter square. So when it is completely open, it reads that value. So once it reads, note down P1, P2, P3, RPM, time taken for 10 revolutions in the energy meter reading, and this one, vacuum gauge reading. So these many things you have to note it down. And here, time taken for 10 centimeter rise in water level. Okay, so to do this, you have to close this valve. Here you have to close this valve completely, operate this and close this valve completely. So when this gets closed, the water starts filling in the tank. So wherever you start, you start, but from there 10 centimeter rise in water level, time taken to rise 10 centimeter rise in water level. So that you have to do it. Once it is done, you open this completely. This completes first trial. Okay, now second trial, we have to operate only this valve. Okay, slightly you close this. How much you should close?
you should close this till your P1. Till your P1 from 1.6, it has to go to 1.8. Till it reads 1.8, you keep closing this valve. The moment it reads 1.8, retake all the readings. That is P1, P2, P3, speed, time taken for 10 revolutions, time taken for 10 cm rise in water level, and here pressure gauge reading. Pressure gauge reading. Okay, so these readings. Then third trial, again close this valve, delivery valve. How much? From 1.8, it has to read 2 kg per centimeter square. So like this, note down all the readings. Fourth trial 2.2, fifth trial 2.4, like that you can do it. Maximum you can go up to 2.2 kg per centimeter square. That's all. Okay, so start from 1.6, go till 2.2. So in between, number of trials as per your requirement. Okay, so this is multi-stage centrifugal pump. Thank you.